Hello from Fairshare IT Services. Along with the IT, we also run our translation and teaching business for Japanese. So Japanese to English and English to Japanese. And we have got around 120 students as of February 2021. And they are like, you know, into multiple batches. Now, our challenge is, as usual, making sure that we get more and more students. So what do? We, of course, advertise in papers. We also, distribute brochures. So I'll give you a challenge. Like, you know, what happens is when we distribute the brochures, we really do not know our audience. We concentrate on locality and then distribute the brochures. But you know, most of our brochures that we get printed, they get wasted. So here, Facebook ads, that comes to a great help, you know. You can get a better return on investment by advertising your business only to potential leads so that you're charged only for a limited number of people. I wish I could do it by distributing brochures by hand, because one disadvantage of doing the Facebook ad is that I don't get to see the body language or the comments of my potential lead. So that's the disadvantage in case of Facebook ad. But even after that, considering that disadvantage, I think focusing only on the potential lead does make a lot of difference, and hopefully it will give a better return on investment. So we are also in trying that. We are not really sure if it's going to be very beneficial for our Japanese classes in acquiring students, but I'm going to give it a try, and then while I'm trying it, I'm trying to share with you. So while I'm trying to teach you, there are a lot of things that need to learn myself. So, but let's start with the step number one. The most important part here is that the advertisement that you do, or you know, it's called as like, you know, the focus is here is boosting the post. Like, so whenever there is a new Japanese batch starting, we put a post on Facebook. So that post needs to be boosted, in the sense that when I put a normal post, it only goes to my own acquaintances. But here it will be shown as an advertisement. But one important thing to remember is that when you post it, make sure that you post it on your Facebook page, business page. You can search on that and create your own business page. That's a separate topic, or I'll create one maybe later on if you don't know. But it's a very, very easy thing to do. So you just go to Facebook and you'll see pages here. Click on pages. I have already created a Facebook page for Fairshare IT Services. So I recently created it. So, you know, I'll just go there. And then there are two major sections that you will see, on the page that we'll be exploring one by one. So the first one is creating a post. I think this is easy. This is exactly same as you create the post as an individual user, and you know, when you create it on a page. So not too many things to disclose here. Then the second one is the main one. So this is the one we'll be focusing more on. That is boost a post. You know, so basically you advertise it. Okay. So how do you when I created the post, this is how the post looks. Yeah. So I'm gonna explain about like our batch, JLPT N3 online weekend batch, when it is starting and all that. Then I put an image to make it a bit more attractive. And then I'm gonna click on boost post. You know, I'm gonna check this boost post box and then post it. So it anyway gets posted on the Facebook page, right? Now what happens after this, or how many things you can do, that is the interesting part. Okay. So then the second section, boost a post, right? So when you click on that, it basically shows you list of posts that you can boost from that particular page. So I'm gonna take this as an example. Unfortunately, I took the screenshot after actually boosting it, so it is showing it as boost again, but otherwise it will show boost post. Yeah. So let's go through one by one. What are the different controls and amazing controls that are provided by Facebook? Right. So first of all, you need to figure out what is the goal of your post, right? Is it to get more messages, or is it to get more calls? Exactly what is it? So in our case, it was to get more website visitors. So I selected it as a get more website visitors. So then what is expected here is that when you have this as your goal, then it means that there has to be some link somewhere. Now, as you can see, I got this website link where I am expecting people to click. Okay. Now the second thing, is the audience. Now, this is the best part, actually, you know. So this is where there is a lot of learning needs to happen. So you know, how do you select your audience, right? So if you see it here, you'll find out there are so many things that you can control. The first thing is the location of your audience, right? Now here you can go by cities. So like for example, in our case, most of the students that come to our online class are from Hadapsar area, they're from Pimpri Chinchwad, they're from Pune in general, Mumbai in general, they're from Satara, Sangli, and other places. So what I did is, instead of focusing on the whole India or maybe US, we start focused on, you know, students or location where we know that the students are coming from. So that this way I can restrict the amount of people, the number of people that my advertise is going to be shown to avoid any wastage, right? Okay, then there are other things that can be controlled. You know, you can control education, their financial status, their life events, if they are parents with like kids, their relationship, work, then their interests, like, you know, business and industry, and you can see the whole list. I mean, you know, as you go and actually try the steps that I'm telling you after clicking on the boost post, you are going to see like all of that, and you need to explore it by understanding your own audience first. Yeah, so now let me go through what I did for Japanese classes, right? So I'm interested if there, you know, if the people, or especially, you know, the young generation, if they are interested in Japanese food, then there is a high chance that they will become interested in learning the language also. So I selected the Japanese cuisine as the one of the options. Then another thing that I selected is, there are many writers who are translators also, so they might see Japanese translation as one of the career options. So that's why I selected writing as one of the options as for targeting the audience. Then this is the interesting one. You know, this is something we learned by experience, that you have got many students who are, you know, not even in their 10th, maybe 6th or 7th. They watch these Japanese anime movies like manga and all that, that even I have not really watched a lot, and they watch that and they get fascinated with Japanese culture and Japanese language. And there are many such students who have joined us. Then also there are people who are interested in making such kind of movies. They're interested in those digital, you know, digitally editing and, you know, those kind of things. And they also like join our classes because they want to learn the language. So that is why I selected anime movies. Okay, this is not a big deal. You know, like people who have lived in Japan, like for example, in our case, we lived in Japan for 16 years, and then our daughters at that time were younger, so they picked up little bit Japanese. But then when they came back, like we thought that, you know, they have stayed in Japan for so many years, so why not teach them Japanese so that, you know, they can learn more and they can get opportunities in Japan because they were, you know, like they're born in Japan and all that. So this is also like a no-brainer, right? So I selected this and quite a few more, actually. You know, I'm not gonna bore you because these are details which are very specific to Japanese teaching business, and none of those will probably apply to your business. So you might want to explore on your own. So what do you explore on your own? So these are the areas that you need to explore on your own, like, you know, like demographics, then interests, and the third part is behaviors. Okay, so you explore that on your own for your own business, and you ultimately, when it is done, so you can boost the post now. So, and you know, the most important part here is that it kind of tells you exactly how many people, like, you know, that you can reach, and what is the total budget. So total budget you can control. So, you know, I'm spending hardly $2, which is, you know, maybe 150 rupees per day for 5 days. So as my marketing partner Rohit Fadnis, he pointed out, this is like way way cheaper than you know, like hiring somebody and then asking him to make anything go anywhere close to this. But again, as I told you, the disadvantage of this is that I don't get the feedback. Like, you know, people who looked at my site, maybe, you know, they went to the site, they saw the details, their feedback, their body language, that why they are not registering to my classes. So that itself is a big learning lesson, right? I mean, I'm learning from people who join our classes, as well as people learning from people who are not joining my classes. So I don't get to see that feedback, but that's okay. You know, still this is like a way cheaper than hiring a person. Then you can boost the post, and then ultimately you can see the report like this for every post, how many people it has reached and how many people have actually clicked on your link. So after this is done, you also get to see like bifurcation by people, then placements and location and things like that. So we can probably go into the details of this once you actually set up boosted your one of your posts. So you keep on getting this report also, which is also great, because sometimes when if you hire a person, then he may not be able to select the audience and report you in a disciplined way like this technology does. So I hope this was helpful, and in case you can do it by yourself, that is great. But if you cannot, then FairShare can help you at a very reasonable price. If there is any issue, please do contact us. And also subscribe to this channel and like this video and share it with your friends and family. Thank you so much and stay safe.